Hello all the awesome people out there, my name is Kiro and welcome back to this Let's Play of Pokemon Black Nuzlocke. So last time I was asking you guys what Pokemon I should start with, and the votes have been cast. There were 5 votes in total. Not that many, but 5 is better than nothing. So as you can see on the screen right now, okay, you can't see it because no one voted for Turpic at all, so no love for that one. Sorry Turpic, no one loves you. Anyways, this one guy here voted for Snivy, so you can probably guess when there was 5 votes that the last 4 votes was these 4 people here, and they all voted for Ozawatt. So Ozawatt it is going to be. Is this the Pokemon you want? Yes, that it is, because people have voted that. Takeda choose Ozawatt. And I got one idea for a nickname from Strawberry Vaporeon to what to name it. And as you can see on the screen right now, she said that I should name him Jack after Samurai Jack. So that I will do when I can nickname it. But anyways. Okay, I'll take this Pokemon. Charon. Actually, I found out that the Charon is pronounced Charon because it's come from the word Cherry, I was about to say. Cherry. Like the... I can't remember what... It's called, berry. Why couldn't I remember that word? Okay. But, after the berry, cherry. So, Charon. Cherry, you can... that's yours. That one's yours. Oh, God. Hey, how come you got to pick out my Pokemon? Never mind. I wanted Snivy from the start anyway. Yeah, right, you did. Everyone has chosen a Pokemon, so that's that. Hey, I know. Let's have a Pokemon battle. Honestly, Bianca, even though you're still weak Pokemon, you shouldn't have Pokemon battles. Oh, sorry, I can't read. Even though there's no weak Pokemon, you shouldn't have Pokemon battles inside a house. Don't be a worry rat. Those little ones are weak, like you said. We have to let them battle so they get stronger. It's settled. Takira, get ready for Pokemon battle. So our first battle. Versus Bianca. That music is not Celtic. It's been such a long time since I played this game. You're challenged by Pokemon trainer Bianca. Bianca sent out... Okay, there's love of Turpic. Bianca likes it. So, let's see. What do we have? Fight? So, we have Tackle and Tail Whip. And I will, of course, tackle it because... Tackle. I am... Holy fuck. That was not... back? That's not fun at all. How did it hit so hard? Please let me win! Well, this will be a very short Nuzlocke. Actually, the Nuzlocke first starts when I get the Pokedex and Pokeballs. But still! I don't want to lose my first battle here! Holy fuck, that was scary! Oh, please let me attack again! Yo! Holy fuck! That was freaking close, man! You defeated Pokemon Center. The Pokemon of both sides did the best, I think that you were saying. Oh, and you can actually see when I record this. Watch! You are saying when I'm... Oh, wait. Oops. How on earth? I mean, wow! Takira, you're gonna be an awesome trainer someday. I can tell. No doubt. Bianca, would you take a look around? Whoa. Oh, what happened? Wow! Pokemon, amazing! So little but so strong. I'm so glad that I get to have a Pokemon. Oh, sorry about your room, Takira. You are completely hopeless. Here, I restore your Pokemon for you. Sharon healed Bianca's Pokemon. Takira, your Pokemon needs to be fixed up too. And he healed my Pokemon. Hey, Sharon! How about you battle too? With all you know, I'm sure you can battle without turning the room into a disaster area like I did. I believe you're right. It'll be no problem for me to keep that room from getting any messier. Can it get any messier? Besides, it's not fair if you two are the only ones who get to have fun battling. It's decided. You'll be my next opponent. You'll be my opponent in your first Pokemon battle. Our first Pokemon. I can't read. Let's see what you can do, Snivy. Takira is challenged by Charon. So let's see how this is going. It can only go better than before, hopefully. Ah. Hope I just don't lose again. I didn't lose. Hope I don't lose. Like that. Don't do any critical hits on me, man. That shit was just so too scary before. I finally become a trainer. Everything starts from here. Yeah, I will just tag you to death. Leer, what is it that does? It's oh right, it's the defense thing. But if it just leer too much, then I will just tackle it to death, I think. Isn't that how it's supposed to work? And so now we use tackle. It should not kill me, but it get me close. But I'm fine. No hard feelings here. No death and my Oswald growth to level 6. Player defeated Pokemon trainer Takarin. So that's a Pokemon battle. What do you think it was? I made a strange blunder in my first battle, but this feeling, I'm finally a trainer. But first, you better go apologize to your mother about this messed up room. I better come too. It was so cozy in here. The bed is a mess. The plant is a mess. The carpet is a mess. At least my computer still works. My floor's a mess. They didn't destroy my controller. Or my Wii U. I'm a Wii. Okay. First off, menu. Options, because I have some options I have to change here. First off, text fast, band screen on, style set, sound stereo save before, that's fine. Confirm. Because I want to be able to not swift out Pokemon in battle. That's more fun than that, when you're doing a Nuzlocke. I think, maybe I'm dooming myself. Oh god. Anyways, I'm very sorry about all the trouble, ma'am. Well, we can clean up. Cleaning up? No worries, I'll take care of it later. Shouldn't you be on your way to meet Professor Juniper? Yes, thank you. Please excuse us. Come on, let's go thank Professor Juniper. I'll be waiting in front of the Pokemon Research Lab. Oh, wait! I gotta go home first! Thanks for having us over.
They destroyed my room, Mom!
My, Takira! Pokemon battles are so lively, aren't they? I could hear the Pokemon cries clear down here. That sure reminds me of my first Pokemon battle. Oh, and you know, after a battle you need to rest your Pokemon. Oh right, I didn't rest after the battle with Charon. I rested after the battle with Bianca! Oh god, I can't remember names! Your Pokemon are looking great! Now, if you're going out, don't forget your cross transceiver. X transceiver? Well, cross transceiver, X transceiver. Okay, I take that. You're going to thank the professor too, right? Better get going, honey. Okay, Mom! What's on the TV?
It's time for today's personal assessment and horoscope. So what's today's star sign, Dr. Astropuff? If you please.
Ah, if you were born in October, your sign is Lampent. You have good sense and a very balanced person. You make even-handed choices. Try to show an enthusiastic spirit and all will be well.
What's the lucky item for the Lampent sign?
Well, carry of carry a choice scarf. It's fashionable and you'll shine as your attack with only one move. Thank you so very much. See you next time.
Well, it's anything important here. Goods are ranged in the shelves in the very orderly fashion. The trash can is empty. But Mom, you can't throw out all the trash. I have to look if there's trash in the trash can. It's chock full of Pokemon books. And photo collect. Anyways, let's go out here and see what we can find. It's spring! Last time I played it, it was winter. Time goes so fast. So, let's start off by... Okay, so that's the lab. Because Karen is there.
Do you think that traveling with Pokemon changes people?
Yes, me too!
Traveling and thinking about many things can definitely make a difference.
So, but yeah. Why haven't I gotten to nickname my Pokemon? Have I goofed or something? I can't remember. I'm pretty sure I only choose my Pokemon, I haven't got to nickname it yet. For some reason. Weird. But let's take a look at it actually. So right now it's level 6. And it has a cry nature. Cry nature means that it has up in special attack and its speed is down. And it has torrent that makes water type moves be more strong in Indesina Pins, and I had Tackle and Tail Whip, so not that much yet. But yeah, why didn't I get to nickname it? I really wonder why. The power of science is amazing. Now you can use infrared to do all sorts of things in the blink of an eye. Yeah, I know that. But also, thank you all people that actually answered the question of the day while I'm at it. There were some people, and you can see the answers on screen right now. So thank you again, as I can see many of you like different Pokemon. For starters, a good portion of you is actually on the Mudkip side, so... And then we have... what was it? We have... we actually have one Ocelot also, so that's kind of nice. But thank you all so much for answering this question. And I have to.
No, no, a thousand times no.
But I'm a good trainer who got a Pokemon and everything. I can totally go on an adventure. It's okay. It's fine. I'll be waiting for you in front of the lab, okay? Oh, poor Bianca. But yeah, I will give you... As you can see right now, there is a question of this video, actually. So I hope that the few people that already have answered the question of the video will also answer the next one. And as I said last time, I can see some of you have got it wrong, but I don't blame you because you're probably... You trade from other PokeTubers, but when you're answering my question of the day, it has to be QOTV, not QOTD, just to make it sure again. So, but the question of this video, I will think is going to be... What is your favorite type of Pokemon? Like, the typing. If it's a fire, water, grass, that kind of thing. So my favorite typing is actually I'm kind of split, but I think my most favorite typing of Pokemon is actually fire type Pokemons. I have always started them when I played games. I always started with a fire type Pokemon. And on a momento, don't mind my husband, dear, he's just being overprotective. All children go on an adventure with Pokemon. It's part of growing up. Yeah, it is. And...
What nonsense is this? How could my daughter, who knows nothing about the world, be going on a journey with Pokemon?
Nah, because she's a Pokemon trainer now. Old man. Bianca, do you have anything in your trash? Nope. But yeah, as I said, what is your favorite typing? As I said, mine is fire because many of my favorite Pokemon is actually in the fire type category, like Charizard, like Blaziken, and Infernape actually is also one of my favorite fire starters, and so on. Entei, for that matter, is actually also one of my, and there's a lot of Pokemon in the fire typing that I actually like a lot. So yeah, I will take fire as my favorite typing of Pokemon, but you can answer down below as always, and I will showcase some of the answers in the next video. So, let's see, this must be Charon's house, I think. Yeah.
Hey, Shakira, I heard from the professor. So, you're getting a Pokemon, eh?
Oh, you already got it?
That sure is a cute Pokemon. And you're all finally starting your journey as trainers. Well, let me read you a passage from a book called Adventure Rules. The X button is vitally important for trainers. Never forget that.
Okay. Old man, I will remember that the X button is very important. I have no idea what the X button does, but I will remember.
That Charon, I'm sure he's at the laboratory. He's so, how should I put it, delighted, or better, something I can't pronounce.
Fuck. Well, he actually has a very clean room for a boy. I'm impressed. Not like my room is a mess. So, But also, as I also said last time, I really want people to come with suggestions what to talk about when I play this game here, so I'll probably just walk around and say whatever people saying here. Not in a specific voice, I'll probably just read. I heard that there are a lot of Pokemon and many different people in the world. When I heard stories about them, I got very excited. I will probably mostly give more important people voices, so just so you know. But yeah, I will just stand still here for a second and say that I also wanted you to give me suggestions to what I should talk about in this, when I do this list page, because I will probably just ramble a lot otherwise. And actually Strawberry Pony gave me a suggestion to what to talk about, and I will do that right after I have been to the professor. So that's a secret, okay? Okay.
Okay, let's go meet the professor.
No. Oh, I can't walk away. God damn it, I hope.
Anyways, let's look at this.
Hey there. I've been waiting for you, young people. Let me introduce myself again. My name is...
Professor Juniper. We know your name.
Come, Jaren. This is not a time to take things lightly. Today is a day to remember always, so it's best to behave with some formality. That being so, once again, my name is Professor Juniper, and I am researching when and how the creatures called Pokemon came into existence. Oh, that's unusual. You already had a Pokemon battle, so maybe that's why. I feel as though your Pokemon have already begun to trust you. By the way, would you like to give your Pokemon a nickname?
Yes, thank you! So I hadn't messed anything up here. So as I said, Momo gave me a nickname, so this one is going to be called Jack. J-A-C-K. K-K-K-K. Yeah.
Oh, I see. Are you okay with that nickname?
Yes, please.
Jack is its name. That's such a great name. As for why I gave all of you Pokemon.
It's for the Pokedex, right?
Pokedex?
I am astonished. Nice work, Jaren. I have already studied Pokemon extensively, haven't you? Still, let me explain everything from the beginning, for everyone's sake.
Pokedex is a high-tech device that automatically records the Pokemon you encounter. So I want you free to visit many places and meet all of the Pokemon in the Dinora region. This is my request. Takira, Jaren, Bianca? You go on an adventure to complete the Pokedex.
Will you not?
No!
Okay, I will not take this in a long turn, so I will just...
Okay. I mean, yes, Professor. Thank you very much. Because of you, I can become a Pokemon trainer exactly as I always wanted.
All of you, thanks. You have gave me the best possible answer.
And I got a Pokedex.
Yay!
Next, I need to teach you how to meet Pokemon. Please meet me at Root Run.
Okay.
Since the professor has asked us, it's okay to go on an adventure, right? I can explain, I can explore and maybe find out what I want to do in life. I think I like that.
Of course. We can travel however we want while we complete the Pokedex.
So, that's our next goal, to complete the Pokedex. Why do all people in this city have clean trash cans? And why isn't there a one button? I probably don't have the shoes to be able to run yet.
Come on, Takira! Wait up!
There you are, and what did the professor have to say? She asked you to complete the Pokedex. I can't believe it. Well, exactly, I can. I already knew she was going to ask. That's why I brought you these. This is why I brought you three of these town maps. Take them with you. Yay, I can see the town now.
Actually, it's the world map, not the town map, but okay.
Here you go, Jaren.
I'll take good care of it.
And one for you too, Bianca. Thanks so much. As for your room, Takira, or what's left of it, no need for any of you to worry. I'll take care of tidying up. Okay, Takira. And Pokemon, they are so cute, but they have enough power to destroy a bedroom. They're really something. With Pokemon like that at your side, you'll be safe wherever you go. I'll let your parents know. I hope that, in addition to Pokemon, you'll find lots of places you like in the Dinor region, and become wonderful adults. Have a great trip.
If I use the town map, I always know where I am. That is certainly helpful. Shall we head to Route 1? The professor is waiting.
Let's go! Takira, hurry up and come too, okay? I will just... I'm going to miss this town. I will probably never come back again.
Bye, Mom!
I'm taking a little break from cleaning up. You and your Pokemon should take a break too. Good trainers don't push their Pokemon too hard.
I haven't done anything since last time.
You and your Pokemon should all be feeling their energy again. Now you can go anywhere. Okay, I can go upstairs and check my room.
Yeah, it's still a mess. You haven't even cleaned up yet. God dang it, Mom. But yeah, as I was saying before, Momo actually gave me a thing to talk about. So what she wanted to me to talk about is how, and I quote her now, how did you get into Pokemon and when? What's your best Pokemon experience? Well, I will probably talk about that in a little while, but yeah, because story again.
Takira! It's this way!
What happened to her voice?
Bianca says if we are staying a journey together, she wants us all to take the first step at the same time.
Hey, Takira! Let's all take the first step on Route 1 together!
Okay, here we go.
One at the two at the...
That was stupid. Anyways.
Oh, I wonder what will happen. Is this so exciting?
It sure is. Come on, the professor's waiting.
I'm sorry to have kept you waiting.
You didn't.
No, that's now that everyone's here...
Oh, that was Karen that said that. Oops.
Now that everyone's here, I'll explain. The Pokedex pages updates automatically whenever you meet a Pokemon. Moreover, it's set up so that you obtain even more information when you catch a Pokemon. To make this clear, I'm going to demonstrate how to catch a Pokemon.
A wild pet rat appeared. So let's see if she can catch it. She will find it properly. But yeah, I will try to answer. I will wait a second. I will just take this battle, then I will try to answer Momo's question. So, un momento. Please do this battle fast, because that's. I really hate those sequences where they have to teach you how to catch Pokemon. When you have played all of the Pokemon games, you know how to do it. So, there should more be doing know how to catch Pokemon. Yes, no, answer thing, and then you can just move on. I actually think they have it in one of the games, where you don't have to see how to catch a Pokemon. But I can't remember.
Did you see that just now? Here's how it goes. Step by step. First, reduce the Pokemon's HP. Pokemon that still have all of their energy are difficult to catch. If you can, use your Pokemon moves to make the Pokemon you want to catch fall asleep or paralyze it. And to wrap this up in the best way, I have a gift for you. Some Pokeballs. So the Nuzlocke starts from here. From now on, everything I do counts. Professor Juniper, Pokeballs are used for catching Pokemon and for carrying the Pokemon you catch. I'm going on ahead. I'll be waiting for you at Akumula Town. Akumula Town, I think that's how it's pronounced.
So you've got to say that Pokemon jump at you in the tall grass. I head into Akumula Town too.
I think I'll go too. I'm looking forward to the next town so I can go shopping for Pokeballs. Wait a minute. Hey, listen. Takira, Karen? I thought of something fun.
But we need to get it going. I'm imagining that Professor's waiting too.
Will you just listen a sec seriously? Why don't we see who can catch the most Pokemon? The person carrying the most Pokemon included the one we received from Professor Juniper is the winner.
Actually, that sounds interesting. If we'll fill up Pokedex pages, so I'm sure it will please the professor too. Okay, well then, until we reach Akumula Town, take care of healing your Pokemon at your own house.
Me and Terpik will do the best for sure. Bye bye, friends.
So I will not catch any mini Pokemon. I will actually only catch one on this road. So, but yeah, now that we do that, I will go into this. And my first Pokemon is a pet rat. So how this goes is that I have to hit it a lot. And hopefully it does not die. If it do, I may not catch it. I can't catch it if it dies, so. And also, if I kill the first Pokemon I encounter, I may not catch it anymore. Unless I am on another route and I meet another pet rat. I have to check out something. I can't remember. It's just if I need another pet rat or if I meet a pet rat or in its evolved form. I may not catch it because that's a copy. And I may not have a copy Pokemon. That means two of the same. But I will check that out for the next time because I probably won't get to a new route where I can catch the same Pokemon twice. Just yet. But D-stain ball? Yes, okay, so our first new partner is a pet rat. And I have an idea to what call it. Using food stored in cheek purses, they can keep watch for days. They use their tails to communicate with others. So, give a nickname to pet rat. Yep, my pet rat should have a nickname and it should be called this name I'm just giving it right now. It should be called Timon. The name is from The Lion King. I think Timon and this is kind of the same animal in some way. So that's what I'm going for. Yeah, probably not that same, but I'll just go back to my house and heal a little because it actually gave me some damage. This one is not that strong, so I can just bash it. But yeah, as I was saying, Momo asked me to talk about that like I said, it was how did I get into Pokemon and what's my best Pokemon memory? So, I actually got into Pokemon really early, actually before the games came out. I was buying some magazines from Nintendo, some really big ones when I was younger. And I was a newspaper boy at that time, so I earned my money to get the magazines when I was young. So I had always been a Pokemon, not a Pokemon, but a Nintendo fanboy when I was younger. And I bought these magazines, and in one of them, they talked about when they come out in Japan.
stuff like that before they actually came in Europe, because they have some segments of things that came out in Japan. And there was that Pokemon thing coming out, and I didn't know what it was. I just actually the magazines it was in English, and at that time I couldn't read English at all, so I was looking at pictures and stuff like that. And I come across this article about the Pokemon in English. I couldn't read it at that time. I read it later on. And together with that article, there actually was a big poster where the first 150 Pokemon was on, because it was just before the release of Pokemon in Japan. And because of that, I had that poster to look at, and I thought, oh, those creatures looking cute and stuff like that. Later on, like I think 2 years later, the game actually was announced for coming in Europe and stuff like that, and I'm living in Europe. And again, in the magazines, there was a segment again about Pokemon coming out in Europe and stuff like that. And I thought, I should probably get those games, because actually I could read, I started to be read English at that time. So I was like, not that good though, but I was like, maybe I should get those games. And I got the Pokemon Red as the first one, and I put it up on my DS, and not my DS, my Game Boy Brick DS, the old Game Boy Brick that I called it, that used too many batteries, and I would train a little before I go up there. I have totally forgot to take up on much new Pokemon. As I said, I got the game, I played it a lot, and it was fairly fun. I had fun with it, and I couldn't read English that good, as I said, so most of the game I didn't know the story, what was going on and stuff like that, but I had fun with it, and again, the type of game it was really fun, because I loved the... Actually, Pokemon was one of the first games that came into the RPG genre of games. Ooh, I learned Water Gun! And I would just... Do I really not have the running shoes? That's how I first came in contact with Pokemon. It was through that magazine. And because of Pokemon, actually, to answer your second question, what's my best experience with it? My best experience is actually that many of my... I didn't have that many friends when I was younger. I was the big kid in the class and stuff like that. I was kind of the nerdy guy, like people are when they're... Some people are when they're young. And that meant that I got bullied a lot when I went to school, and didn't really have that many friends at school. So... I was playing Pokemon, and luckily my cousin got the game, and in his class there actually were some more nerds that played the game. My cousin was 3 years younger than me when he got the game. He's still 3 years younger than me, not that he get older, like, what the hell. We were a little older at that time. I think it was about around the time when when Gold and Silver came out, then he got into the games, because before that he didn't have a Game Boy, so he couldn't play them anyways. And when he got it, someone from his class also got the Pokemon games. And I kind of got into getting to know people like that there, but it was not that much yet. But after that, one of his friends actually was playing the Pokemon card game. And I had been collecting the cards for some time, but I have never played it at all, because I didn't know anyone that collected the cards and stuff like that. But he told me that there was, where I lived, there was a shop that actually had a Pokemon League where you can play the card games, and there were a lot of people that also played Game Boy games and stuff like that, so you could trade with them and have fun like that. So one day I took into the city and played the card game with the people in there, and I had a ton of fun. And really, I get to know so many people that I'm actually friends with today because of that. And many of the friends actually had the same nerd culture as me, like they love Pokemon, they love anime and gaming and stuff like that. So I learned a lot of people that have the same interest as me. And because of that,
I think I've leveled all of my Pokemon up to level 10 just here, so I can talk while doing so. But because of that, that's actually a good experience, because I get to know so many people because of that. And I had so much fun playing the card games. I'm not collecting card games anymore, because later on it gets too expensive and there were coming new cards every time, and it was just hard to keep up with having the money for buying the cards and could play it and stuff like that. So I kind of dropped out of the card game, but I still play the Pokemon games, as you can see now. I have all the new ones also, so not all of them, but I have the new generations games and I have a ton of fun playing them and stuff like that. So, but yeah, that's probably how I got into Pokemon and playing the game and what experience it's given me, because I think without Pokemon, I probably would not be where I am today. Maybe I would be playing, making Let's Plays and stuff like that. Maybe. I can't tell, because that's hard to know, but I will probably do it, because I will love to play games when I was younger too. I played a ton of games all the time. Like, the first console I got was, I was 4 years old, I think, and my parents got me for Christmas, they got me this Commodore 64, some of you may know it, and it was like the big thing when I was a child at that time. So I had a lot of fun with that, and some years later I got enough money to buy a Nintendo, later on Super Nintendo, a PlayStation, Super Nintendo, Nintendo 64, and so on and so on. And where I am today, while I have my PC, actually PC is something new for me in some way, because I got my first PC when I was 18 years old, so that's 12 years ago, and I didn't know anything about PCs at all. So, and comparison today, I have a lot of experience in using a PC now. But yeah, now I'm playing games on PC. I have a Wii U, I have a PlayStation 3. I am trying to get a PlayStation 4 also, but I have a DS, 3DS, PSP. I really have everything, I think. I don't have an Xbox, but the most reason I don't have an Xbox is actually, I don't think, there's no games on it especially that I want, that haven't come out for either PC or the other consoles. So I have an Xbox One controller though, but that I'm using on my PC, so but without Pokemon, as I said, I don't think I would have the friends I have now, and I don't think I would be who I am today. I would probably be not another person, but I will probably have some other experience, have other friends than I have now. Because many of the people I know because I started out as playing Pokemon, and some of them were into Pokemon. And they went to anime, and then I found out through them that there was an anime club in them here where I live also. And through that I learned even more people to know, and that actually started my friendship with so many people. So that's actually my story of what Pokemon has done for me. So as you can see, it has been a great experience so far, and I think I will keep evolving, and I probably will still keep liking Pokemon, because even though that I'm 30 years, almost 31 now, oops, I don't want to heal again. Even though I'm almost 31 years now, I still love playing the games, because I still think they are fun, even though they are for children and all that, but I still have fun playing them. And the type of gamer I am in the Pokemon universe is actually, I'm a power gamer. I do two things when I play Pokemon games. I have power games to just get strong and beat everyone up, to overpower myself like that. I'm not a competitive player, I can't do that at all. Not good at that, but I'm a power gamer, so I keep getting stronger and just bash everything in my way. And I'm a collector, so when I play Pokemon, I'm going to get every single Pokemon in the game, not like every single one and just evolve them until their final form and then have it there. No, I'm going to get one of every one, so I will have a Bulbasaur, Ivysaur, Venusaur, and so on and so on. So that's how I play these games. But yeah, let's continue the story, and I will probably grind through doing let's plays just to keep up with the levels. So I don't know if people want to see that. I don't know if you want me to make a grinding montage, or you just want me to grind between let's plays and then see the let's plays when it comes to there, and what have happened and stuff like that. So please let me know that in the comment also, besides the question of the day, the question of the video. Sorry, I'm screwing up here. So, and still I haven't checked out my pet rat. Okay, let's look at it. My Timon has a hardy nature. And that means that nothing, apparently. It doesn't change anything. So, but it has keen eye, prevents other Pokemon from lowering accuracy. And it has Tackle and Leer, and it's level 4, so I have to train it a little, I think. But let's continue the story and see if they want to talk to me.
Takira, are you going to compare yourself with Bianca? Both Bianca and I have two Pokemon with us.
I also have two Pokemon with me.
How about it, Takira? Do you want to compare which one of us has the most Pokemon with them? Seems the number of Pokemon Takira has is 2.
We all have the same number then.
Incidentally, if you check your Pokedex, you'll see how many Pokemon you found and how many you are caught. I'm off to a Cumulat town. The professor is waiting.
My thing is ringing. Take it, take it. Takira, pick up the X thingy.
Hello, how are everybody doing? You and your Pokemon are getting along great, right?
Oh, Professor!
I think that Sharon just says that.
Right now, I'm in front of a Cumulat Town's Pokemon Center. I'd like to show you around, so hurry on over it.
Anyone? Look, I can't read.
Okay, the Pokemon Center.
Okay, the Pokemon Center. Right.
Okay, see you.
I have no idea.
Well, I'm going on ahead.
Everyone leave me?
So, but yeah, we are in the first town now. And I haven't lost any Pokemon, so that's a good start. So, but yeah, I have answered Momo's Christian thingy. So, if any of you have any questions of any sort related to Pokemon, or just something you want me to talk about, you can leave a comment down below about it, and I will I will see how many comments I get on questions to answer, and I will look into how many I can answer doing a video. If I don't answer your question in the next video, or if you have in the next video afterwards, then just type the same comment. I will probably notice you because you are typing in 2 times and I think, oh, I haven't answered that, and I will probably look into it and get the time to answer you in the next video then. Because it's not like I don't want to answer you, it's just if there are a lot of questions, I can't get through all of your questions in one go. But yeah, I will go and talk to Professor Juniper.
Ah, Takira, there you are. Traveling with your Pokemon is truly one of the joys of being a trainer. Please follow me. I'd like to show you the most important place of a town to know.
The Pokemon Center, isn't that all I need to know?
This is the Pokemon Center. Don't you feel better as soon as you step through the door?
Okay, let's start your journey.
Oh, wait! Wait for me!
A Pokemon Center is a truly incredible place. You know why? Because your Pokemon can be healed. And what more? It's absolutely free! A Pokemon Center is the trainer's best friend. Here, Togekiss, give it a try.
Hello, and welcome to the Pokemon Center. You restore your entire Pokemon to full health. Would you like to rest your Pokemon? Yes, thank you. I have these two. Can you take good care of them? Okay, I'll take your Pokemon for a few seconds. Thank you for waiting. We restored your Pokemon to full health. We hope to see you again.
Actually, I don't like that comment. We hope to see you again. Isn't that kind of like, we hope that your Pokemon get hurt one more time, so you can get back here and we can heal them. No, but really. Anyways, okay. Now that your Pokemon have been restored, I'll show you how to use the PC for the Pokemon at the Pokemon Center. This is the PC. It's free for any trainer to use. You can store Pokemon in your PC boxes or select Pokemon stored in your PC boxes to take along with you. In addition, if you catch a few Pokemon while you have 6 Pokemon traveling with you, the Pokemon you just caught is sent automatically to the PC network. Surprising, isn't it? Amazing. Here's something else that's cool. If you select my PC, I evaluate the progress of your mate on your Pokédex.
Professor!
Someone's PC? On that screen. Who is someone? Very good, Bianca. That's a great observation. Good question. And I'd like to say more, but for now, just ignore that and go ahead and use the PC. Someone is the person who made the Pokemon storage system. Someone. I'm sure you'll meet someday. Okay, let's move on. Now this is the Pokemat. Oh, Pokemarket. This is the place to buy useful items and sell the ones you don't need anymore. The gentleman over there will help you with a small smile. So let's wrap this up. I've given you a basic of being a trainer. I'm going to head back to Nuvema Town. I probably pronounced all the towns correctly wrong. One final thing. When you get to Strachan City, go and meet the inventor named Fennel. She's a friend of mine from long ago, and I'm sure she'll help you on your way. Best of luck, I hope your journeys prove to be the adventure of a lifetime.
Welp!
Oh, what should I buy? Potions and Pokeballs are definitely important. Thinking. Well, I will buy. I have 4,000, so I can buy 6 Pokeballs. And I know I have 1 potion because one guy on the street gave me that, but I will think I will get 6 more. And with that, I am poor. And I still wish that I had some running shoes.
Sounds like something's going on the plaza.
Well, let's have a little look, say.
I think I'll do the same thing in just a moment. Actually, that just a moment will be next week. So, just to summarize here, question of the video, you can answer it with the QOTV in the comments. And the question is, what is your favorite type of Pokemon? You can leave the comment down below and say that. Also, if you have any suggestions to what I should talk about, please let me know. If you have some good ideas for nicknames for Pokemon, please leave them also, because sometimes I'm giving stupid nicknames to stupid things. And with that, remember to answer everything before Wednesday, because I will record these videos on Wednesdays, because I have to edit them and I have some I have someone else to edit my these videos for me, so, and they would like to have some time to do it. So please answer to, before Wednesday
and on with that. But yeah. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you can give me a thumb up. You can hit me up on Facebook or Twitter or write a comment down below. You can subscribe for more awesome videos that I have made, and I hope you all will have an awesome day. So until next time, farewell.